What are we today then? We are stars. Every born again Christian is a testimony to the Lord Jesus Christ. A star to reflect the power and holiness of the Lord Jesus. To reflect Him in His life. To perfect Him in His speech. To perfect Him in His healing power. To perfect Him in His resurrection. To reflect Him in every way.
Amen.
That He was reflected to us by God the Father. We are stars. Watch. What kind of a star should you be? This star was not guided by its own power. It was guided by the celestial powers of Almighty God. And if we're ever going to reflect sinners to Christ, we've got to be guided by the Holy Spirit. Romans 8:1 said, there is therefore now no condemnation to them that's in Christ, that walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. If we're going to be a star to reflect the light of Christ, to bring sinners to Him, we've got to be guided by the Holy Spirit. Right? And we cannot be ordinarily. We have to be unusual. We cannot be usual because God's people are peculiar people. They've been through the ages. Although peculiar, yet the star was brilliant.
Amen.
Not brilliant in world's education or world's affair, but brilliant as sacrifice before the Lord. We prostrate ourselves as the Magi did in the presence of the King of Kings to reflect His light. You're a star. Every Christian is a star to guide the lost, to guide the weary, the foot of the traveler, to those who are seeking. Then the star cannot be guided by itself. It must be led by the Spirit. It must reflect the brilliancy of God in its life to abstain from the things of the world and to live godly and soberly in this present life.
Amen.
It must reflect the light of its great one, its shine. What are we to do then? To rise and shine the light of God.
Amen.
To the dying, enveloped darkness of this world, we are to reflect and shine the presence of the Lord Jesus in His resurrecting power.
Amen.
As He is yesterday, so is He today, to reflect Him. But remember, then the star again, when it's finished its course, it takes no honor. The star just brought the man to their destination and showed them that perfect light. And we as members of the body of Christ this morning, friends, we are God's lights. But we take no honor to ourselves when we've got our patience and our person that we're leading. When we've got them, we must dishonor ourselves and lead them to the great and perfect light, which shineth to light the way of every man that cometh into the world.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus Christ. Not a myth called Santa Claus. Not some church by denomination. But that true and perfect light. Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Let us pray.